Inspire TV broadcast is brought to you by Lace Up with Lax, ending homelessness one step at a time. CBA Sports, your sports construction specialist. A Joke for Lax, the Andrew Oswald Memorial Fund. And Children's Healthcare of Atlanta Sports Medicine, dedicated to all better.
We welcome you in on a 59-degree overcast day here in Marietta, Georgia. It is the AJ for Lax Festival here, live from Pope High School here on the Crossfire TV. Joel Hillsman, Bob Lombardo here with you. Our first matchup today will feature the Woodward Academy War Eagles and the Cambridge Bears. And you think, Bob, about this Cambridge Bears ball club coming in at 4-2. They are number 10 in the recent AJC poll. The head coach is Jacob Hale, and the director of lacrosse is Mike D. Andrell. You're on the field. We were able to talk to them before the game. I mean, what can we look forward to from this Cambridge?
Well, I talked to the Cambridge coach, Coach DeAndrea, and he was telling me that right now they're sitting second in their area. Their only area loss, I believe, was the Blessed Trinity. And, you know, they're feeling, he feels good. He thinks if his kids are going to handle the ball, they should do all right. It's funny, AJC has them 10th, Lax Power has them 23rd. You know, so they've given up, they've scored 67 goals and they've given up 36.
And they're coming in, as you mentioned right there, through five games or through six games. That area is 5A Area 3 for the Cambridge Bears, and they will be in the Carolina Blue today. On the flip side, it'll be the Woodward Academy War Eagles, and the War Eagles coming in. They now are 38th in the Lax Power Georgia poll. Head coach is Andy Pons, and they come in off of a 12-6 loss to McIntosh on Thursday. That McIntosh team that we saw earlier in the week, a very good team. So Woodward Academy filled with multiple sport athletes. You love to see that. A number of football players on this team. The one guy we'll need to keep an eye on will be number 9, and that will be Ben Wilkins.
Yeah, we have Ben Wilkinson. He's going to play at Richmond. University of Richmond, so he's got to be a baller, so we look forward to watching him play as well.
Bears number 18, Ben Clark.
And then also Will Crane for the War Eagles will be going to Swanee, so he's a college commit that we will keep our eyes on today. And then of course we have the face-off as we get ready to start right here. It'll be Woodward and Cambridge. Cambridge in the blue, Woodward, they are in the white, and we are underway in the 10th annual AJ for Lax Festival here at Pope High School in Marietta, Georgia, and the face-off won by Woodward Academy.
And there's a quick whistle.
Possession will go over to Cambridge now.
Possession Bears.
In goal for Cambridge will be Ben Clark, number 18, and for Woodward Academy, it'll be number 1, Will Romero.
Easy clear by number 24, Tyler Wald.
Flips it over and they have a substitution, and now Cambridge will be working on offense for the very first time. They flip it over now. Here is Britton. Britton gives it off, and here's Wilkins. Wilkins hit in the middle, and they're going to come out, and here comes Woodward coming out on the clear. Crossing the wing area into the midfield and going to try to get it down into the box, and they do. Good clear there. Max Richardson there. On the clear. So Woodward working in the box now. Robbie Tucker has it. Now swings it and dips it over. And there's Will Crane. Crane 11 in white for this Woodward bunch. And then working back in behind is number 8 unlisted here on white. So we'll have to check that out. Ball is on the ground, scooped up, and the goal will come out with it in Ben Clark. Cambridge working on the clear, and they go through. Chase Darnell down into the left alley, steps into the box, and here they go with Griffin Chambers. Chambers now will hold it. He's in the box. Now steps back into the left alley. First quarter just underway. Tries to make a nifty move. Long pole really bothering. up to the top. They'll spin it back this way, and now here comes.
There's your first goal of the day.
Goal, Kenny Wilkins.
Wilkins with the goal, and he gets that goal at 9:57 for Cambridge.
9:57 remaining in the first quarter. Bears 1, War Eagles 0.
Wilkinson has 12 goals and 5 assists on the season, so he just tacked on his 13th.
Jamie Wilkins out of the midfield scores, and we'll have our second faceoff. Woodward Academy won the first faceoff, but it immediately had a turnover and had to go over. Now here we are. Cambridge will win this faceoff. 1-1 in the faceoff department, and stroking this way and coming down with it is Austin Wally. To the left now, here's Griffin Chambers. And they kick it back out to the top and work it around. Now here's Bennett Ferguson. Ferguson out high at the box. Lazy pass as he popped it over to the left of Will Britton. So the Bears with an early 1-0 lead operating, going to the top of the box. Here's Wilkins. Wilkins moves to the right. The pass was behind his teammate, and he was going for 16 unlisted on the roster. Max Fleming.
Possession, War Eagles.
Good hustle by Max Fleming. Good work on the ground ball.
Woodward Academy coming out, trying to get the clear now. And here's Will Crane. Crane gives it over. A bad pass. They were being sloppy with it, trying to stay onside, and that's what hit him.
Yeah, he was concerned whether he had a teammate staying back for him or not, and kind of lost his balance at the midfield line.
Two-man crew here now. And glad that you're with us here on Lacrosse Fire TV. Now, moving into the box with it is Will Britton. There's a shot. Hit the post by Jack Sadegan. Sadegan shot, hit the post. Scooped up ground ball now by the Bears. Moving to the left and angling is Austin Darnell on the attack. Gives it back out to the top. They'll work it around. Here's Sadegan. Sadegan gets it back to the top now in Britton. Britton now going to move to the right. Spin back toward the middle. It's not there. Now he dumps it out short. There's a low shot. No. Wide to the left. Griffin Chambers. Chambers' shot was low and wide to the left, Bob.
Yep. They're moving the ball pretty good, Nick. Taking their shots. Wonder when they have an opportunity.
Coming in from behind. Shot no again. Coming from behind and quickly. That was Max Fleming, who was coming from behind the cage. Out to the right and shot it back. He went wide left. Possession will remain with the Bears.
Yeah, well, he needed to take another step up across the GLE. He was a little bit, that was a tough angle for him.
Britton will hold it. Now he pops it out to the top. Here's Sadegan. Sadegan with a move. Sadegan worked on by the defender. Broke free. Hands free. Shot. Goal! Zach Sadegan.
Goal. Sadegan.
Cambridge with a 2-0 lead. Second goal coming at 7:58. Jack Sadegan.
7:58 remaining in the first quarter. Bears 2, War Eagles 0.
So Sadegan with a goal and Wilkins with a goal so far.
And Austin Walling.
And Sadegan, we always talk about getting hands free. He made the move to the middle. Not only was his hands free, his feet was free and a good shot.
He got everything free on that shot.
Yes, he did. Face off. Cambridge will win it. So Cambridge now with the advantage, 2-1 in the face off. They are dominating here early in the moment. Here's Tyler Wall. Wall being worked on, smacked from behind, being checked hard. But they'll give it up, and now here's Griffin Chambers. Chambers working to the left of the box. And they will set it up. Jake Meyerholt on now for the Bears. They get it over to the right. Here's Vassell. Chase going to send it back in, and now Chambers going to work from behind the net, and here's Griffin Chambers. Chambers going to try to make his move. Come out to the left of the cave. Good long pole action defensively there to prevent him from making his move. Gives it back out to the top now, holding.
And long pole's Max Richardson, a linebacker, going to play at Boston College.
Vassell, a goal! Cambridge coming out on fire! Chase Vassell with the goal. It is 3-0. Cambridge, they're making it look very, very easy in full control.
7:10 remaining in the quarter. Bears 3, War Eagles 0.
Right now, the firepower is coming from their midfielders.
I love it. The firepower here on Lacrosse Fire TV as we take a look at our Lacrosse Fire TV instant replay. And Cambridge quickly out now, 3-0. And we're coming up now with just on 5 minutes to play. Cambridge will win another faceoff. So now they've got a 2-faceoff advantage. The Bears operate now. Here's Chambers. Chambers is to the left of the block. And they go in behind. Long pole action defensively there by from Xavier Fleetwood. Shot. Goal. They are doing whatever they want. That one coming from Zach Fuhrer of Infielder. It is 4-0. They are pouring it on early.
6:48 in the quarter. Bears 4, Warriors 0.
Zach Fuhrer with the goal for Cambridge, and this one comes at the 6:48 mark.
And another midi puts it in.
Yeah, the midfielders are doing a lot of work, and now Woodward Academy has to call time. They have to. They've been bombarded by goals here quickly, and we've only played it 5:12. 4-0 to Cambridge Bears. Man, we're looking pretty good under Coach Jacob Hale.
Well, if you look at it, Woodward pretty much got off the bus and started playing. They didn't have much of a warm-up. I don't know if they had problems on the road, but I think they'll settle down and make this a closer game than what we're seeing once they get their feet.
This is the 10th annual AJO Flax Festival, and this benefits Andrew Oswell Memorial Fund here at Pope High School Stadium. Glad that you're with us here. Joe Hillsman, Bob Lombardo. The sun is peeking out. If you can hear on our mics, the wind is whipping in pretty good. Little overcast, 60 degrees. This, the first of five today. First of five games. And some pretty good stuff lined up for the rest of the day. We were talking about the rankings. AJC has Cambridge at number 10. Cambridge out of Milton, Georgia. That's a Fulton County school. And they are in the 5A Area 3. So out of the timeout now, it's face-off time. We take a look there at the face-off. Right down the line right there.
White went early. You can see, that was a great view because you see him move his stick early and Cambridge comes up with the ball.
Yep, Cambridge will get that face-off. And, man, they've been deadly with it right now. We've been playing on this left end of the field all day, it seems like, so far. Chambers now has it. Chambers looking to work back in behind. He spins to the middle. Now cuts back in. Longpole really guarding him defensively. Tough right now. Now here is Meyerholt. Meyerholt now gets it to the top now and holds it back out to 32. That's Jamie Wilkins. He's already got him a goal today. Wilkins a move. A shot! Goal! Wilkins another one.
That was a pretty shot. Came down the right alley. Split dodge to his left. Took a nice hard left-handed shot and put it right by the goalie.
Cambridge, man, just now making it a routine habit. 5-0, Wilkins with his second goal of the day.
Face-off, Stephen Elliott and Austin Walling.
It's interesting. Oh, he's not on the field right now. I was going to say that Wald for Cambridge is like a specialist on the wing, but he's not out there right now.
Face-off going to come up. Fell down. Cambridge with the win.
You got to push.
Oh, and no. Yeah, it will go over to Woodward Academy. So Woodward now will get a break. And here they operate it now with Will Crane. Crane steps into the box and now steps back out, being worked on by the long pole of Nick Herrick.
This is really Woodward Academy's first offensive possession.
Technically, it is. A second one. They had one work early and then had that turnover. Robert Tucker now goes in the back. And back in behind now, here's Graham Dixon. They'll work it back out to the top and out of the box to Kyler Pilch. Shot! Saved! Pilch shot was saved. Good job in there by Ben Clark. So now, here comes Cambridge trying to get the clear, picked up the ground ball. Now working back in behind is Herrick. Herrick now will be safe with it and go back to Clark. Clark will fire it up on the clear to the right wing area, crossing the midfield line, and here they come. Long pole action into the box. We'll peel it back to the right alley, and they can set it up. Dancing over to the right side now, holding is Tyler Wall. Wall's pass on the ground, so that'll be scooped up. Bennett Ferguson. Ferguson got popped right there near the right wing area, still on the ground. They keep it on the ground, and he scooped it up for the ground ball. Ferguson now will take it and hand it over, and here's Vassell. Vassell already with a goal today as well for these Cambridge Bears. Substitutions made by the War Eagles. Vassell, right alley. Now goes back in behind the cage. Fleming working behind the cage to Griffin Chambers. Chambers now wanted to go out to the right. Come back to the left in the middle. Shot! Oh, what a save. Max Fleming was right in front. Good save right there. And that's what they needed. Coming in, Will Romero with the save. They're going to have to get a stop, Bob. They cannot continue to allow Cambridge to just score at will.
No, they need to pick it up a little bit on the defensive end. Seems like the long poles are taking care of their business. Because all the goals come from the midfield.
Ball kind of sloppy and picked up now by Vassell out top of the box. He gets inside the box, being checked on by the long pole of Will Crane. Fleming cut through, was unable to get it to him. And the Barons will set it up now. Working in behind, and here is Britton. Britton made a move, got free, shot, low goal. No, yes, it's a goal. Yep. Will Britton made his little juke move, got free, hands free, and a goal at 3:53. They're just taking their time. It is a six-goal first quarter right now so far for the Cambridge Bears.
I don't want to sound like a broken record, but that's another mini scoring.
It is.
So I think Cambridge has felt that the defense for Woodward is the strength is at the poles. Not that I'm saying that middies can't play defense, but right now they're getting a little bit outplayed by Cambridge.
And winning the faceoff, Cambridge 5-1. Here's Chambers now holding. He's in this left alley, number 5 in the Carolina Blue for the Bears. Chambers now will spit it back out to the top as they make the substitutions. Here's Wilkins. Wilkins fires it across, now scooped up and bounced off the chest, and he'll hold it and work with it as Fur. Fur has already got him a goal as well today. Juke move, going in, going right onto the cage, goes back behind. Chambers pump fake, spins back to the middle. Chambers going to go inside, shot, save. It's still in the front. Romero saved it, but the ball is still loose on the ground.
Chambers, save, Romero.
They're battling for it, and now Romero will come up with it, and now Woodward will try to come out on a clear. Pop! Got laid out. Wilkins with the hit. Ground ball rolling, picked up near the right wing area by the Bears. What a pop. Stick in the middle now. Here comes Wilkins, a shot. No, deflected and goes back behind, and they chase it down, and it'll go to Woodward. Man, what a pop by Wilkins.
He did put one on him.
So Woodward now will attempt to get the clear. They had one coming again, and then their man got cleared out. Pun intended. On the ground, scooped up, not checked. Fight for it, loose. It's in the Woodward box. Cambridge kicks it back out to the right. It's going to roll, and Cambridge going to come away with it. Woodward having all kind of trouble here in this first quarter. 2:35 to go, trailing 6-0.
Woodward in possession. We'll see if they can get something going.
Yeah, Woodward will retain that possession. Excuse me. There's a shot right in the middle, save. Big Ben Clark, the junior goalkeeper, swallowed it up with the save. So Clark now will come out and try to go for the clear here with the Bears. Get it up ahead now to give it over to Darnell. Darnell now, they get it and they clear. Successful clear in the middle. Goes back behind. He was trying to go to Chamber. Nick Herrick was trying to go to Chamber. Woodward now will come out with it. Woodward Academy, they are in white. And right now, trying to stop the Bears, who are really eating these Eagles alive right now, 6-0. Romero out of goal as they will come up and try to clear into the right wing area, across the midfield line. And holding it now is Mac Richardson. Richardson into that right alley. He's long pole.
He's a big guy, but he's light on his feet, that Richardson.
When they clear it back, Malik Curry has checked in now for the War Eagles. So now here they are. We'll set it up with 90 seconds to go, first quarter, trailing 6-0. A barrage of goals from the Bears to begin this one. Woodward working in back behind the cage. Now long pole action really defensively from Eric Drucker.
And now you're seeing Cambridge really press out on their defense.
Trying to apply that pressure. They've got this 6-goal lead. Here's Keller Pilch. Pilch now plays catch at the top of the box. They go step inside the box. Crane trying to break free, but as you mentioned, Bob, the defense, they are making sure they put a body on you. Very aggressive. Under a minute.
You can see how far out these Cambridge defenders are coming to play.
Juke move. Shot. Crane. Save. Ben Clark with a save. Saw it all the way. Ball is on the ground. Still in that box. And he's going to scoop it up. Ground ball picked up. Now here coming a clear. And a juke move. Move to the middle. Faked on the pass. Then he lost it. Scooped it back up. Across the midfield line over the left wing. Here he comes with 30 seconds. They get it into Chambers. Chambers is left of the box. Makes a move. Heading right for the cage. Got pushed. Didn't matter. Shot low to the wide to the right. No.
Shot. Chambers.
Once again, that was 24. Tyler Wald coming up with the ball on that last Frey for the ground ball, and he's been doing a good job picking up ground balls for Cambridge.
Chambers comes out. Okay, shot. Right in front, Romero.
Shot,
was able to save it. Save. Final Romero. 10 seconds of the first quarter. Romero will spin it over. And there's Kate Thomas.
Very good clear.
And we are at the end of the first quarter. Cambridge, a dominating 6-0 lead at the end of the one right here on Crossfire TV.
I got a high ankle sprain going for a rebound.
Injuries are part of playing.
I got hit catching a pass and broke my collarbone.
So it's good to know that the sports medicine doctors, therapists, and athletic trainers at Children's Healthcare of Atlanta are experts at treating young athletes. If your child suffers any kind of sports-related injury,
I got hit and dislocated my shoulder.
Bring him to Children's Healthcare of Atlanta.
Thank you for your incredible generosity as we continue our mission.
Welcome you back inside New Hope High School Stadium. Joel Hildman, Bob Lombardo here with you. The AJ for Lax Festival, the 10th annual festival here on Lacrosse Fire TV. Cambridge 6-0 after this first quarter. Bob, what did you see from the Cambridge Bears?
They were relentless. They came out right from the first faceoff and just got after it. I think they've kind of shocked Woodward right now. So Woodward has to settle down the second quarter and see if they can't start stemming, getting some offense going.
Flip the field now as Woodward will be in the white. And moving right to left, Cambridge now in the navy blue. Ajo for Lax. Flag down coming in a two-man crew. And the table again will be on the opposite side.
We got a slash, I think.
Slash?
Yes.
Will be a man up advantage.
For a minute.
1 minute now, and our first man up advantage of the day. Cambridge winning the faceoffs 5-1. Make it 6-1 now.
Well, this is a good opportunity for Woodward right now. They're a man up. Let's see if they can put one in the goal and kind of slow down the bleeding.
Will Crane, the midfielder, as we whistle it in for play. Stepping into the box on the pass. The War Eagles now trailing 6-0. Have a man up advantage. Like you said, Bob, perfect opportunity to put one in the cage. Turnover. An unforced turnover. Very careless. And you mentioned Woodward was very late arriving, and that sometimes that mentally can get to you if you don't get your proper warm-up. Cambridge was here and looked like they were ready and had their proper warm-up, and they just came out and gotten off to a very, very fast start.
I got to agree. I mean, warm-up can comprise of your physical warm-up and your mental warm-up. And jumping off the bus and just getting into it, it makes it tough to get any of those things ready. We got a turnover, and I think we're going white.
Possession War Eagles.
Cambridge does have the turnover. Cambridge coming off of a 17-2 victory over Pinecrest Academy on Thursday. That it was a season high for goals with 17. And then it was a season low for goals allowed at 2. So a pair of season highs. There's a shot low and wide to the right. No good. Kill or pilch.
Prevent the War Eagles.
War Eagles have it back in. Dixon. Dixon has it now. We'll spin it back out to the top. Checking in his Crane. Penalty is over.
Again, these guys are pressing out on him. They're not going to make anything easy for Woodward.
Woodward trying to be patient, but the defense, as you mentioned, pressed out on him. Here is Dupree. Dupree all the way around the box, and they go back in back behind the cage for the War Eagles. Here's Dixon. Spins it back out to the top. They'll do something else. Here's Crane. Crane trying to get a running start. Wall on him defensively. Knocked him on his keister.
It was good. Wow. It was good defense. He drove him way outside the alley there. Made it difficult for him to get a good shot.
Cambridge right now, you're talking about the defense and the pressing. They are dictating this game offensively and defensively. Ball is on the ground. Still not free. Cambridge trying to get it free. Ball rolling up near the midfield line. They fight for it. And let's see.
Got to push in the back on the Woodburn.
Over and back.
Battling right there, almost kind of like a box out for it to get to the midfield line. Here comes Cambridge now operating. Max Fleming. Fleming will take it and go back in behind. 9:37 to go. Second quarter, Cambridge with a 6-0 lead and a big, big barrage of goals in that first quarter. Here's Wilkins, who cracked the seal on the scoring. Inside, he tried to dump it off softly, was looking for Meyerhold. He wasn't there.
But that's the War Eagles.
And it will go over to the War Eagles. So here is Xavier Fleetwood. Xavier Fleetwood, the long pole. With it now is Woodward will try to come out and get the clear. First goal is the hardest goal.
They got to get the ball moving. They got 20 seconds to get it in the box.
Yeah, may get a failure to advance. And they have not advanced past the midfield line. Crane into the wing area. And they get it into the box just barely. They'll work it back in behind. It's on the ground. And get it into the cross of the War Eagles, and they will set it up now and try and get something on the board. Dixon spins it back out, and here's Malik Curry. Curry flips it to the right to Pilch. Pilch wants to get a running start. Got checked, moves to the left. Shot, low, save. Ben Clark had it read all the way. The big goalie for Cambridge, Ben Clark.
That's why he's been 62% on the season. He's having a good year.
Bears clear.
Jucker now gives it over, and here is Meyerholt. Meyerholt into the alley, and let's see. Offside?
Yeah.
Offside call. On Cambridge. It will go over to Woodward Academy. So the War Eagles now will try to clear. 808 Woodward Academy in the white, moving right to left. Kate Thomas has it. Still trying to get the clear. Past the midfield line and now into the box. And we'll step back. Will Dupree. Dupree in the right alley for this Woodward bunch. Taken away. A turnover. And here come the Bears on the clear. Get it into the box.
Ooh.
Bad pass. He was going for Chambers. Turnover.
Got a little anxious on that pass.
And you know, Woodward can score. Season high this year for them. 20 goals. That came against Fayette County. Fayette County taking their lumps a lot. They gave up 30 goals to a team as well. But Woodward put in their 20. Coming in at 10.4 goals per game. Allowing 6.2 goals per game against. Well, they're right there at that mark with 6 given up today already. Here's Thomas. Thomas into the box. Thomas going to spin it back out. Good defensive effort. As you mentioned, the Bears really pressing up, and they make you, they're dictating what they want you to do with that ball. Going to try and be patient with it. They'll flare it over. Now here is Crane. Will Crane back out to the top. And they'll work it up. Now here's Pilch. Pilch has the most Division I offers from on this Woodward team. He has 3 all in lacrosse. Now, there's some football players on this bunch as well. Crane shot. Clark, a save. Man, Clark is doing work in that.
Save, Clark.
In the front, ball on the ground. Scooped up ground ball coming away with the Bears. And here they'll come on the clear. Chase Darnell down the right wing area across the midfield line. And into the box. And he's going to go all the way. Shot. Let's say Romello.
those long poles like to pull the trigger whenever they get a chance.
And you get the shot, you would too. Coming back now, here's Woodward Academy trying to get the clear. Into the middle. Thomas into the midfield. Get it down and into the box.
Nice clear. Nice clear by, what was that?
Kate Thomas,
that's it.
They are trying to pick it up. You can feel Woodward now picking it up just a little bit. Still being sloppy with the ball. 8 is not listed. I'm going to go out on a limb and say that's number 9, Ben Wilkins. That's a big boy. Ben Wilkinson, as we mentioned in the open, going to Richmond for lacrosse. So here is Curry, Malik Curry, twirling it in his cross, makes a move. Sadegan came in defensively, shot high, chase down. It'll stay with the War Eagles.
Shot Curry.
Well, it's good to see Woodward getting some shots off. That's a plus right now.
Exactly, because they spent a lot of time on defense there in that first quarter.
Maybe they're beginning to settle down and get their feet under them and
get that second win going.
That's it.
Wilkinson, a shot wide to the right.
All right, it's two shots in this possession. That's a good sign.
And we'll retain the possession. Woodward now will be patient. Thomas Bennett. Bennett pass low. Wilkinson picks up shot. Clark has been money in net. Ben
Clark.
Clark
Wilkinson.
And here come the Bears on the clear. And here's Wilkins. Wilkins into the front of the box. Shot! Wide. No, man, they tried to get that one in there. That was Darnell on the attack with the shot.
But that's the Bears.
It will stay with the Bears. And now we have a timeout. Timeout called by Cambridge. And they have a 6-0 lead. We've kind of settled it down. 4:28 to go, second quarter, right here. Lacrosse Fire TV.
This Lacrosse Fire TV broadcast is brought to you by Lace Up with Lax, ending homelessness one step at a time. CBA Sports, your sports construction specialist. A Joke for Lax, the Andrew Oswald Memorial Fund, and Children's Healthcare of Atlanta Sports Medicine, dedicated to all better.
ForLax.com.
Welcome you back into Pope High School and the AJ for Lax Festival. We're taking a look at our lacrosse fire commits. Ben Clark, Will Crane, and Ben Wilkinson. Right now, Ben Clark in goal going to Bucknell. He has had a strong day so far for the Bears.
Oh, he's been playing outstanding. I mean, Woodward's been having trouble getting shots off, and when they do, he's right there to stop them. So, you know, they have to solve that puzzle.
Cambridge taking a look at him, and that was beautiful. Navy blue, a rather new school in the North Fulton area. That is in Milton, Georgia. 5A school, Area 3. And we've mentioned they come in the week 4 polls of the AJC state poll at number 10. The first six goals came so quick, they looked like a highly ranked team.
Shot Wilkins, possession Bears.
Ben Wilkinson shot is no.
And part of it, Woodward's picked up their defense.
That is true. Like we said, they've gotten comfortable. They literally showed up 12 minutes before faceoff. Spinning back in behind now for Cambridge's Darnell. There's a shot, Wilkins, wide left, no.
Shot, Wilkins.
They will chase it down, and let's see who will retain the possession. Will be Cambridge.
Bears.
Nope, it will be the War Eagles. So the War Eagles now will come out and try to get the player.
The War Eagles.
Max Richardson goes and scoops up one of the balls, and they'll get ready to go. He fires it over to Romello. Romero now will come up out of goal, and they will try to clear. And he's going to have to come all the way up. Might have to go across the midfield line himself. Doesn't want to. Gives it over to Kate Thomas. Long post steps across.
Or he'll clear.
And they get that clear. Now I got to get it into the box. Pass. Shot.
No!
Oh, there you go. A good clear and a goal coming to the left. That goal scored by Robbie Tucker. And Woodward Academy is on the board.
3 minutes and 27 seconds remaining.
3:27 to go here in the second. It is now 6-1.
On the faceoff, Tucker Kimbrough and Austin Walling.
Well, Tucker on the attack with the first goal, and sometimes the first one is the hardest one to get. Let's see if they can continue to sustain the momentum.
That'll give them a little confidence.
Faceoff time. Ball is on the ground. Faceoff won. It should have been won by Cambridge. Who's going to pick it up and win this faceoff? It's almost like a hot potato now.
That was a push in the back.
Push. And let's see. Coming off, limping off the field, Austin Waller. and a timeout call by
Woodward
Pond and the Woodward Academy War Eagles with 3:13. This is an opportunity here, Bob. 3:13, you just got your first goal. If you can get another goal, start building that momentum before halftime, could put you in a pretty good situation.
Oh, yeah. If they score here, 6-2 ball game. And they get a little confidence going into the half. It could be a whole different game in the second half.
We are glad that you're with us here on the Crossfire TV. Joey Up and Bob Lombardo. This is the first of five games today. We'll take a look at the rest of the schedule. Walton Johns Creek, Lambert Lovett, Harrison Centennial, and Pope Westminster will be the nightcap. And Bob and I look forward to our 2 o'clock game. That'll be Lambert and Lovett. That's going to be a fun game.
Oh, that should be good. They're the top, in the top five in the state, I believe. So that'll be a good game.
We talked about Woodward Academy and the football connection. Woodward Academy team lost in the state semifinals to Buford. Seven players on the lacrosse team were on that state semifinal high school football team. And that was a game, man. I know they really wish they had it back. But the big man who was the real deal, Evander Holyfield's son, Elijah Holyfield, was the running back for that squad down there for Woodward Academy. Out of College Park, Georgia. Keisha Browns came from there. Delino DeShields has came from there. Just off the top of my head in recent and not so recent years. Out of the timeout now, Woodward will try to build momentum, trailing 6-1 as we come up late here in this second quarter. Working around, here's Crane. Crane will have it. They go to the top of the box, and we'll work it now with Thomas Bennett, who is in. Crane, a shot. Clark, a save.
Shot, Crane, save, Clark.
Bears will look to clear. And let's see. Any penalty call?
Goalie interference, I believe.
Bears. Tucker Kimbrough here wanting explanation of what he did.
He hit the goalie stick while he was still in the crease, and that's illegal. If he has possession and he's inside the crease, he can't hit his stick.
Check it. That's 12, Graham Dixon. 12, Graham Dixon, not 18, Tucker Kimbrough. Hopefully, Tucker, you'll get in. I'll be able to make that one up to you. Cambridge gets it now into the box. Shot wide to the right. Backed up with 2.5 to go. And the Bears will come back and keep it in possession and play. Here is Fleming. Max Fleming going to go around the cage to the right. Back out to the top to Jackson Egan. Deegan now gives it to Chase Vassell. Vassell moves down the lane, stop, spins to the right, is not there. Gives it back in behind. Now here's Lehman. Zach Lehman will go crisscross, gets that pick from behind. Long Paul bothered him in the middle. Spinning shot backwards, flip save by Romero. Will Romero with the save.
Save Romero.
Romero having to come all the way up again on this clear. Into the middle, Malik Curry couldn't scoop it up. Ball on the ground, won by the Bears, and a ground ball pickup. Great job by Meyerholt. Here's Meyerholt now going to fire it across the midfield line. They move it in Bears across. Here's Sadegan. Sadegan now going to move, come up, and get into the box on the right side. Now he'll step back into the alley.
Flag down.
We've got a flag, and let's see.
Offsides.
Offsides called.
30-second offside penalty.
And that was on Woodward. So now we'll have our second man-up situation.
It's on the War Eagles. Bears playing man-up.
First man-up here for the Bears. Woodward 0-1 in man-up situation. 1:38 to go, and the sun now has made its appearance all over the field in what is supposed to be a beautiful Saturday. Wilkins fires it across. Shot! Goal! Griffin Chambers fired it in.
Griffin Chambers.
All right. The attack doesn't get shut out by Cambridge. Cambridge gets on the board with an attackman.
One for one on the man-up situations for the Cambridge Bears. It is 7-1.
How do you not if attack doesn't score and the middies are doing all the scoring, they're going to be doing a lot of talking on the bus ride home.
Really?
Okay. Oh, yeah.
Attack, the middies, and the defenseman, and then the goal. That's how it's broken down here. Glad that you're with us on La Crosse Fire TV. A tell you, for Lax Festival here at Pope High School. This is the first of five as we now come up on 1:15 to go.
You notice there's a broken stick laying in front of the goal down there.
I see that.
Cambridge, yeah. And in lacrosse, you got to just drop your stick and get off. You can't pick it up. You can't carry it off. You just got to leave it laying there.
You can't keep playing like in hockey?
No, no.
Official timeout off the field.
So they will get it. AJO for Lax.
Turn out we're getting a good day. Weather looked bad last night, but so far.
A little cloudy, overcast, and the sun now has gone back and hidden for just a moment.
1 minute.
When we come up on the final minute here in this second quarter, Cambridge working back in behind. And here's Darnell. Taken away, Woodward. Their defense has stepped up a lot here in this second quarter. On the ground, unable to get the clear. Scooped up by the Bears. Holding call.
It
looks like Ryan Sadegan, Stephen Elliott is injured there for Woodward.
He was bringing the ball up on the right side, trying to clear. Got past one guy, and another guy from Cambridge lowered it, put a little lick on him. And I'm hoping it's not his head.
He's down right near the right wing area on the far side of the field.
I'll tell you what, right now, I was talking to Coach earlier, and Cambridge, as much as they're doing well, their leading scorer from last year, Brendan Fahey, out this year because of a torn ACL that he got in preseason. So if he was on the field, who knows what would be going on now.
Yeah, that is true. A couple of injuries there for the Cambridge Bears. Also out is their long stick midfielder, number 14, Nick Gainham. He is out for today as well.
Tell you what, this has been a well-played game. I mean, we've only had a couple of penalties, and it's always good when, you know, the flags aren't flying.
Elliott up on his feet, walking off on his own power. So hopefully they will get a chance to tend to him and everything will be out all right with him. 41 seconds to go, second quarter. 7-1 Cambridge with the lead, but as we mentioned, six quick goals there in the first 8 minutes of the game. Woodward defense now has settled down. I've only allowed one here in this second quarter as they try to come out and get the clear. And here's Kate Thomas. Thomas now steps across and gives it to Max Richardson. Richardson into the box. Under 30 seconds to go. Curry. Offside's call on Woodward. So Cambridge quickly coming back with 19 seconds. Trying to get him a momentum swinging goal here with Harris. Another stick is down. And another whistle is blown. And all of a sudden now it's getting chippy here in the final minute.
Yeah, bodies are flying now.
We got another injured player out in front of the crease. And that's Harris. Nick Harris.
He brought the ball all the way down. Was thinking about taking a shot. And he took a shot.
He's up and okay, grabs his helmet, and walks off. Training staff asking him his question. Everyone might be needing halftime. The last minute, the way the last minute and a half has gone here in the second quarter.
I'll go in the locker room and do some triage.
Cambridge now with 11 seconds. Into the box. Makes his move. Wilkins a shot wide left. Cambridge will chase it down. They'll have 6 seconds.
Possession Bears.
6 seconds to go. Here's Darnell. Darnell on the attack with five. With four. Darnell going to spin with two. With one. They will not get a shot off. And we are at the end of the first half. The Cambridge Bears, seven. The Woodward Academy War Eagles, one. We are at the half in the opener of the AJ for Lax Festival here from Pope High School on the Crossfire TV.
I got a high ankle sprain going for a rebound.
Injuries are part of playing.
I got hit catching a pass and broke my collarbone.
So it's good to know that the sports medicine doctors, therapists, and athletic trainers at Children's Healthcare of Atlanta are experts at treating young athletes. If your child suffers any kind of sports-related injury,
I got hit and dislocated my shoulder.
Bring him to Children's Healthcare of Atlanta.
So the Andrew J. Oswalt Foundation is based upon Andrew Oswalt in his memory, his death 8 years ago, and we decided to take donations that people had sent and put it towards his memory and create this foundation. So it started off very small and has grown. We've given over $120,000 in scholarships, and it's really based upon making good decisions. Drive safe, make good decisions, and pretty much have fun.
And we started this back in 2006, the year after Andrew died in a car accident. It's really incredible to see the growth of the event. We're just tremendously grateful for all of the people, the volunteers, but also the people that come out every year and just make it the event that it is, because we couldn't do it if people didn't come out and support us. We love to do this because it helps us raise money, and we love to donate money.
We have started an equipment rental program for the boys, so we've had over 1,000 boys start playing lacrosse by using our equipment through our rental program at low cost. So we've been able to get them into the game and help grow the game.
Thanks, AJO.
Thanks, AJO.
We could be heroes. We could be heroes. Me and you. We could be
high ankle sprain, going for a rebound.
Injuries are part of playing.
I got hit catching a pass and broke my collarbone.
So it's good to know that the sports medicine doctors, therapists, and athletic trainers at Children's Healthcare of Atlanta are experts at treating young athletes. If your child suffers any kind of sports-related injury,
I got hit and dislocated my shoulder.
Bring him to Children's Healthcare of Atlanta.
This Lacrosse Fire TV broadcast is brought to you by Lace Up with Lax, ending homelessness one step at a time. CBA Sports, your sports construction specialist. A Joe for Less, the Andrew Oswald Memorial Fund, and Children's Healthcare of Atlanta Sports Medicine, dedicated to all better.
Get your job,
welcome you back into Pope High School, the AJ for Lax Festival here on Lacrosse Fire TV. It's amazing how you work on something all week and then you get here and it doesn't come out the way you worked on it, so I apologize. But it is AJO for Lax Festival. Joe, that's been Bob Lombardo, 7-1 Cambridge in control. And Bob, we saw a vastly different tale of two quarters in that first half. Cambridge came out quickly, 6 goals in the first 8 minutes, and then in that second half, in that second quarter, only a goal apiece. But it looked like Woodward kind of got their legs under them here as we start this third quarter.
They did, and they got their first goal in the second quarter. So The defense stepped up. Their offense is beginning to move the ball a little bit, and now we'll see what they do the second half. And there's that big Max Richardson with the ground ball. See if they clear it. Oh, tough.
6-2 face-off advantage. And Bob, you and I were talking about Max Richardson, a football player going to Boston College. But, man, he uses that long pole well in the opportunities he's had today.
He has. I mean, all their poles are playing very well for Woodward.
Fair player.
It was a barrage of goals in that first. Now, here comes Cambridge in the middle. Picked up the ground ball. And they'll spin it back out to the top. It's on the ground. And a pickup of the ground ball. Here's Wilkins. Wilkins with two goals so far in this contest.
Wilkins, one of the captains of the team, playing well.
Britton a goal, Freer a goal, Vassell a goal, Zadegan a goal, and Griffin Chambers a goal. Those are the seven goals for the Cambridge Bears out of Milton, Georgia. In the middle, shot, goal, Zach Fur. The mini.
Goal, Zach Fur.
Fur with the goal, and it is 8-1, and that goal coming at 10:42.
On the face-off, Tucker Kimbrough and Austin Walling.
So now it is 8-1. Cambridge with the lead. 22, Zach Fur with the goal. Face-off time. Ball spit out. Cambridge will win the face-off. 7-2 advantage.
Tell you that 24 does a great job on face-offs for Cambridge.
That would be Wald.
That would be Wald. I mean, he's come up with a lot of ground balls and helped them clear the ball and get their offense going. And those are the unsung things you see. They don't get recognized for that in the stats so much. But ground balls you do, but, you know, he's getting it in, getting in the box, and getting off the field.
Working in behind now is Cambridge and Darnell. Darnell now spins it back out. They'll work it out. Here's Fur. Gives it over now, and moving is Britton. Britton, shot! Romero couldn't get it. It was wide. Cambridge will retain the possession.
Save Romero.
Romero has warmed up early, too, after giving up those quick goals. And you can see now with Woodward, they have settled down.
And you know, of all the guys that need a warm-up, it's the goalie. You know?
Shot, Fleming.
You notice you go out, watch before a game, the goalie's in that goal right away, working with the coach, just working on, you know, working on technique and stopping shots and getting ready for the game. And he didn't have that much of an opportunity to do that.
Cambridge operating, going back behind the cage now. 8-1 lead, spin move. Good check. Defense came in there by Costin Barber.
Shot, Fleming. Save, Romero.
For the audience at home, when you see these guys sprinting to the end line after a shot, the rule is the guy closest to the end line and closest to the ball gets possession.
Of these two teams, Woodward is the only team that has played an out-of-state team, and they played Wando out of South Carolina, low country schools. Goal in front. And a nice goal in there. Well, Britton with his second goal in Cambridge now. Another fast start. It's 9-1.
9-1 Bears with 9 minutes and 12 seconds remaining in the third quarter.
He just stepped up and let it rip. Ran around the defender.
On the face off.
Let it go hard, right-handed
and
shot.
Austin Walling.
Get ready for this face-off. Woodward had to get their men set. Had one sprint off late. Face-off on the ground.
Play on. Got to push on White.
Push, and it will go to Cambridge.
Pushing on the War Eagle. Possession Bears.
Face-off will remain 7-2. The Bears working in behind the cage. Shot in the middle. Romero with the save.
Shot, Worth, save, Romero.
Here they come out on the clear now. 20 seconds to clear, and it's a clear once you get it down into the box. So here's Romelo, who's had to come up a lot like that, real Romelo. Now he just dumps it into open space. Ball chased all the way up close to the alley, picked up and in.
Warren was clear.
Crane in the right alley, goes back in behind the cage. Good defensive pressure there. I mean, he's really popping him in his Eric Drucker.
We got a push by the pole. He knocked him right in the goal.
Yep, right into the cage. So now here the War Eagles will operate it. Trailing now, 9-1. Long goal of the day came from Robbie Tucker. So here's Crane. Crane in the box. Spits it to Tucker. Tucker now swings it back in behind. And they'll set it up and do their operation as Graham Dixon. Dixon being bothered by the long hold of Eric Drucker. Out to the top. Now here's Crane. Crane top of the box looking. Looking. Steps in the box. Now moves. Stop. Put it. Dropped it. Picked it back up. Ground ball pickup. And they'll go back over to the left and they'll set it back up. Now here's Pilch. Keller Pilch out top. 7:45. Less than that to go third quarter. On the attack. Gonna move in. Pilch looks, shot high. Chase down, Woodward.
Shot, Pilch.
You'll notice that Woodward shots, I mean, they're coming, but they're not getting great ones because these guys are playing good D and pushing them outside the alley, and they're taking, you know, pretty tough angled shots.
We've seen Lambert play today, we've seen them play this season. We'll see them again today. They're very aggressive as well. I think Cambridge right now, so far this season, this is the most aggressive team we've seen defensively.
Defensively, yeah. They press out and they don't make anything easy.
Clear is Darnell coming up on the clear and stepping into the box, having it. Now is Austin Darnell.
Oh, nice shot.
And a goal. Right inside. You know, Cambridge continuing to pour it on. Big goal there by Jake Meyerholt.
This is a perfect example. Watch this shot. We talk about hands free. This guy's draped all over his back, but his hands are free, and he puts it in the cage. Nice, nice shot.
On the face-off,
that was our lacrosse fire TV. Instant a replay. Way to break that one down for Coach Bob Lombardo. He's Bob Lombardo. I'm Joe Hillsman. We are lacrosse in Georgia. Yes, sir. Wind whips in. Feels pretty good. Cambridge in double digits now, 10-1. On the ground and win that face-off, 8-2. Face-off advantage to the Cambridge Bears, and they come in.
Once again, Tyler Ward with the ball on the faceoff, picking up a ground ball. I think he's the leading ground ball guy today.
He is just all over the place today.
And you know what? He just does his job and gets off and is happy with his role, and he plays it well.
Knows his role, knows what he's asked. And as you mentioned, he plays it well. Here's Austin Darnell, on the attack.
Excuse me, fans.
Now going to move into the box. Here is Vassell. Vassell swings it. They'll go back in behind. Now here on the attack. Moving in, spinning is Worth. Tyler Worth making his first appearance. Ball on the ground. Ground ball pickup for Woodward. And Woodward will try to come out on clear. What a pop!
No.
Oh, stick. Oh, man. Come on. That's just a good lick. I'm sorry. Jake Meyerholt, he's the smaller guy, but, man, he laid out a big guy. Woodward has had trouble with control of the ball. They've been a bit sloppy today with the ball.
Yeah.
Tucker Kimbrough.
Unfortunately.
Into the contest, and Kimbrough was the one that got popped there by Meyerholt, and they wouldn't let it go.
Nice stop.
Crease violation.
Crease violation.
Go over
to
Woodward. Woodward now will come out on the clear.
Oregon's clear.
Max Richardson. Get it in, and there is the clear. To Malik Curry. Curry has it and flips it back out to the top. And Woodward will try to set it up with Pilch. Pilch swings it over on the left side. Here's Wilkinson. Wilkinson makes his move into the box. Got hammered, popped around. Ball is on the ground. Meyerholt didn't see it. It's still on the ground. Scooped up. Ground ball one. By the Bears. Darnell, a long clear.
Chase Darnell.
Chambers lost it. It's on the ground. Still on the ground. still on the ground. Chambers now going to have it. Chambers coming in. Chambers over. They tried to go with an alley-oop type shot. No, it wasn't there. Zach Lehman on the attack. I thought Chambers was just going to come in and fire it since he was right there on Cage.
We had a push in the back. We're going. Woodward gets the ball.
Two-man crew.
And for the most part, the refs are letting the kids play.
Yeah. They haven't called anything unnecessarily or just for us to talk about them.
The less we talk about them, the better, right?
That's right. Here's Crane out to the top.
They're doing a good job.
Crane into the box. Crane coming on. Crane was not prepared to shoot, though. They'll work it back around. The War Eagles trailing now 10-1. The Bears, six quick goals in that first quarter. Now they've got three quick goals here in this third quarter. They only had one in the second quarter. Four-quarter game, 12 minutes per quarter in high school lacrosse. Shot wide to the left. No. Shot coming in. That was Malik Curry.
I mean, I think Woodward has to get a little sense of urgency now with under 4 minutes left in the third period, down by 9 goals.
And the defense of Cambridge has pretty much dictated this thing from the beginning. Ground ball picked up. Chase Darnell. Now it's still on the ground. Hit back out. Rolled, and it'll be picked up. Ground balled up by Will Crane. Trying to attack is Thomas Bennett, a midi. Bennett going to come in. Bennett trying to get free. Bennett right on goal. No. Ben Clark came out and met him. Still a ground ball pickup. Here's Crane. Used a little body. Now he's going to check it back out and give it over to Malik Curry. And Woodward will check, set it up again. 3:13 to go. Bennett unable to do it. Cambridge defense not letting them do what they want to do. Here's Curry. Curry spins and now gives it over to Crane. Crane inside the box, just to the right of the box. Going to try to come on. Got defended and checked. Shot high. Good defense there. Ed Drucker, the defenseman there for the Cambridge Bears. And it will go over to Woodward, and Ben Clark didn't agree with that.
I think he called the goalie for in and out of the crease.
In and out, Carl.
And that's exactly what it is. In and out of the crease.
Once you go out of the crease with the ball, you can't go back into the crease.
And now we've got a timeout call.
Timeout, Warriors.
And then timeout time call by Woodward right out here, Lacrosse Fire TV. This is the AJ.
Oh, for Lax
Festival on Lacrosse Fire.
The annual tournament will take place on Friday, June 3rd.
This Lacrosse Fire TV broadcast is brought to you by Lace Up with Lax, ending homelessness one step at a time. CBA Sports, your sports construction specialist. A Joe for Lax, the Andrew Oswald Memorial Fund. And Children's Healthcare of Atlanta Sports Medicine, dedicated to all better.
I got a high ankle sprain going for a rebound.
Injuries are part of playing.
I got hit catching a pass and broke my collarbone.
So it's good to know that the sports medicine doctors, therapists, and athletic trainers at Children's Healthcare of Atlanta are experts at treating young athletes. If your child suffers any kind of sports-related injury,
I got hit and dislocated my shoulder.
Bring him to Children's Healthcare of Atlanta.
Welcome back to Pope High School, the A.J. Flax Festival here on Lacrosse Fire TV. Joel Hillsman, Bob Lombardo, glad that you're with us. Marietta, Georgia, in a game right now. Cambridge 10-1, and they've dominated it wire to wire so far. They have not trailed in this contest. Long goal for Woodford Academy came in the second quarter, and it came from Robbie Tucker with 3:27 to go in the second quarter. So now three straight goals to open it up here in this third quarter for Cambridge. And you've been talking some on air, Bob, but a lot off air about how the refs are letting them play. I mean, we're seeing how physical and how attacking Cambridge defense is with the refs letting them play. That looks like it favors the Cambridge Bears.
You know, I think they both had their share of physicalness. I'm not, you know. But I kind of like the letting them play. I like the idea that, you know, it's a contact sport. It still is. As much as they're trying to protect the kids, there's still some contact involved.
Crane's shot was high and went back into the bushes. We won't play with that ball again. Top of the box now. Malik Clark swings it over. Woodward Academy in the white, moving left to right. Closing moments now here of this third quarter. 2:14 to go.
Shot, Bennett.
And Thomas Bennett shot.
Possession, War Eagles.
Is wide. They will retain the possession for the War Eagles. They call the timeout. Want to be able to get a goal with some momentum here out of the timeout.
Well, they need a goal because if Woodward, Cambridge scores one more, we're into a running clock.
That's right. Mercy rule action. Long shot. It is high. No good by Malik Curry.
I like Malik. At least he's trying to initiate and go to the goal and draw a slide and maybe dump. Because, you know, lacrosse, you got initiators and you got finishers. And Malik seems to be a good initiator. But he needs some help.
It's on the ground. Dixon now going to try to scoop it up and keep the possession for Woodward. 100 seconds less than that now here, third quarter. Spinning into the middle. Crane, pop! Lick shot.
Yeah, they're going to get him for a...
Chase Darnell.
Against the Bears, possession, War Eagles.
He got a little shaken up. That was, well,
they told us that Woodward had the football player.
That was kind of...
And a lot of the football players
are jocking off the field.
Are getting stuck.
But, I mean, on that was a good no-call because he actually spun. He turned on the defender, and the guy, you know, kind of jacked him up. But it was more the offensive guy turning.
Shot wide to the left. It is no good. Pilch. Killer Pilch.
Possession, War Eagles.
They are able to retain the possession now, but they're unable to find that back of that net. Elliott is back in. He was injured earlier. 44 in white.
I'm looking for Bennett to take the ball at the hoop. Yeah, seems that he wants to get a little more involvement. Oh, there it is. It's a goal.
Goal. Killer Pimps. And Ben Clark upset there. So Woodward cracks on the board here in the second half. It's 10-2.
49 seconds remaining in the quarter. Bears 10, War Eagles 2.
So the second goal of the game for Woodward Academy comes off of the cross of Killer Pilch. Killer Pilch with that goal, and now here we are in a face-off situation. 8-2 Cambridge with the face-off lead. Ball popped out. Cambridge picks it up, and they have a 9-2 advantage now. On the ground, War Eagles an opportunity to scoop up that ground ball. Still on the ground, it's scooped up Wilkins. Wilkins now twirling it in his cross, back in behind with 25 seconds. Around, shot low, wide, to the right, no.
John Wilkins.
Yeah, it's always tough when you take a shorty behind because they're not used to playing defense behind the goal. And he made a nice move on that defenseman.
Around the crease and they'll go back in behind again. Good long pole defense there by Richardson. Richardson really roughing him up a little bit. It's on the ground. Richardson couldn't pick up the ground ball. And we are at the end of the third quarter. We move to the fourth. The Cambridge Bears 10. The Woodward Academy War Eagles 2. We'll come back. Fourth quarter action right here from the H.O. Flax Festival on Lacrosse Fire TV.
I got a high ankle sprain going for a rebound.
Injuries are part of playing.
I got hit catching a pass and broke my collarbone.
So it's good to know that the sports medicine doctors, therapists, and athletic trainers at Children's Healthcare of Atlanta are experts at treating young athletes. If your child suffers any kind of sports-related injury,
I got hit and dislocated my shoulder.
Bring him to Children's Healthcare of Atlanta.
And Georgia Tech. Brian King and Under Armour lacrosse here. Great.
Welcome back to the H.O. Palax Festival. Play lacrosse. Make good choices. Celebrate life. HOPalax.com. Joe Hillsman and Bob Lombardo back here with us. We begin the fourth quarter between the Cambridge Bears and the Woodward Academy War Eagles. 10-2 Cambridge. A three-goal third quarter there. One goal there from Woodward Academy in a game in which Cambridge has demanded and commanded control from the beginning. Bob is laughing. You saw it too. What a stick.
One guy thought he was going to lay the other guy out. It didn't work out that way.
10th face-off won for Cambridge. They have a 10-2 advantage. So the score and the face-off, the same. Working now to the left is Cambridge. They are in that Carolina baby powder blue. Working in behind, and now they'll go deep into the bench. Tyler Worth has checked in. Swings it right there in the middle. Holding is Martini.
Good stop.
Croy Martini with the shot. And then there's Will Romero with the save. Romero now will come out on the clear. Got popped around and stuck. They give it back to Romero. Now he's going to go deep clear. And now coming across is Fleetwood. Fleetwood now will get into the box for the clear. 20 seconds to clear. And to clear, you have to get into the box. We're here on Lacrosse Fire TV. Glad that you're with us. And every time we can educate you on the sport of lacrosse, we will. And sometimes if I defer to Bob, it's because he makes it sound better than I do. Shot is no good.
Shot,
Will Crane.
Save. Clark.
Clark still in at goal, and he's had a fine day in goal. Picked up now, and here is Richardson. Mac Richardson with that long pole. Defensively. It'll go back, and they're going to give it to Cambridge.
Out of bounds, possession Bears.
It was good aggressive riding by number 34.
Darnell. 34, Darnell.
Now in
Austin
goal,
Darnell
Bears.
And 47, Chase Darnell. The brothers, and man, they have been very good defensemen so far in this contest. First time laying eyes on Cambridge this year. Impressed. Shot wide. No, it will stay with him. Croy Shot Martini, him in. Coming in now, getting him some burn here in this fourth quarter. Cambridge working in behind. Now he's going to spin back from behind. Working this Meyerholt. Meyerholt, a starter, still in as well. So just sprinkling in a little bit. Miles Copeland is in now. 7 in blue on the attack for the Bears. Nice spin. Shot low in front. No. That was by Tyler Worth. They chase it down. And it will go to
Woodward.
And it is Stephen Elliott, number 44, the mini for Woodward Academy. Shaking up early. Good to see that he's back into the contest. Romero now will come out on the clear. And here is Cade Thomas. Thomas up on the left wing area trying to get into the midfield line. There's the pass over to Richardson. Richardson needs to go ahead and get into the box. Take his time and pops it over to Crane. Crane stepped into the box for the clear. Crane back out to the top. And now here is Richardson. Check it. Not Max Richardson. Wilkinson. Ben Wilkinson was who I was trying to say. He had a jersey change. He's listed as 9 on the white, but he had to come out in an 8. Big boy. Football boy. Lacrosse boy as well. He's going to Richmond. Crane committed to Swanee for lacrosse. Max Richardson is the first team All-State linebacker in Boston College. He's the long pole that has done a very, very good job when the ball has been near him.
Oh, yeah.
Right wing area. Now here come the Bears. Into the box and get it for the clear. Jack Lundstrom in now, the defenseman with that clear. Vassell is back in. Vassell twirls it in his cross. And they go back out to the top. There's a spin and a juke. He almost went to spin. He did not. Just kind of a little hesitation there. Sadegan. Not Sadegan now. That'll be Gruka. Gruka in. So the bag now working in some substitutes. Dylan Gabriel is also in now. Here's Gruka. Gruka going to come on the attack. Got by his man. Gruka a shot. Bounced in. Saved by Romero. Will Romero with the save.
Romero.
This is valuable depth developing time here. 10-2, 8-goal advantage. It's not a running clock situation, but the Bears, Bob, able to sprinkle in some of that youth in there with them.
Yeah, it's always nice to get the younger guys on the field, give them, like you said, experience. Because it's a long season, and you never know when you need the next guy up.
Woodward now on the attack. Wilkinson lost it out of his cross. Picked up by the Bears. Here he comes quickly across the midfield line. Easy clear. A transition break. Here he comes into the box. Vassell got it knocked from behind. Great job of hustling back defensively there by Will Crane. But now they can't recover it. Into the middle. Here's Worth. Worth. Shot. Saved by Romero.
Shot. Worth. Saved. Romero.
A transition and fast break opportunity, and the Cambridge Bears could not capitalize on it. Woodward coming out with the clear. Richardson gets it in, and now here's Wilkinson. Wilkinson down, fell down, stolen away. Ball on the ground, picked up by the Bears, and here they come. Coming out with a clear opportunity, going long. Here's Lundstrom. Lundstrom scoops it up, now going to come across the midfield line. Lundstrom has to get that clear in there, and he clears it into the box. Now he's going to hesitate. Lost it out of his cross, knocked down. Good defensive effort is rolling on the ground in the blue line. Sliding there, great job by Worth. And a penalty on Worth. Nope, out of bounds. And Kate Thomas forced that. It'll be Woodward Academy War Eagle ball.
Hey, I think when he slipped, his foot went out of bounds. So.
Nope, they're going to give it back to Cambridge.
Oh, okay.
So Worth gets it as it's whistle for play. 6.5 to go. 10-2.
Ooh.
Boom. A lot of contact.
Tell you what, when Woodward slides, they slide and they bring the body. They don't just wave a stick.
Bennett Ferguson, a midfielder now in. And he's been worked on by a long pole who just knocked it down. Ferguson was able to scoop it back up. In the right alley, now moving in, Zach Lehman. He's in. Lehman now over to Worth. Worth worked on by Thomas. Shot is low, wide to the right. It'll stay with Cambridge.
Shot Worth. Possession Bears.
If you're just joining us, Cambridge got off to a 6-0 lead in the first 8 minutes of the contest. And right there, they have not looked back. A 6-goal first quarter.
They stop.
A 1-goal second quarter. 1-goal third quarter. 3-goal third quarter, excuse me. Looking at my Woodward stats. Woodward with a goal in the second and a goal in the third. As Woodward now on the clear. New goalie in now, and that'll be Andrew Orton. So Ben Clark's fine day has come to an end for the Cambridge Bears.
It is always nice when you get a backup goalie in, because there's nothing, no experience like game experience.
Offside and an illegal procedure on Woodward, and it will go over to Cambridge. Woodward has not been clicking very well today overall. On the clear, and now into is Gruka. Gruka shot. No. Down low. Goal. Put it in there, young fella. Zach Lehman a goal. It's 11-2.
Goal. Zach Lehman.
Cambridge with that goal here in the fourth quarter at the 5:05 mark. Woodward has avoided the running clock situation. But Cambridge, again, as we mentioned, has been in full control of this contest.
You know, Woodward slowed down Cambridge in the second half, held them to, 4 goals after a 7-goal barrage in the first half. But they just haven't been figured out a way to get the ball in the net for themselves.
Take a look at that faceoff right down the line, and we've talked about it here. The new face-off rule where both crosses must be on the ground and the ref will place it. They fight for it. And it'll be picked up and almost won. Should have been won by Woodward. Cambridge will get the win. Cambridge now 11-2 in the face-off department. It's on the ground again, fighting for it, jostling. Out of bounds. That black line there is the lacrosse line. Black lines here at Pope. And you know, we are at the home of, we'll just incorporate all of this, Holland Frost, who we saw for Georgia Tech a few weeks ago. This
right,
is where he
right.
went to school and played football and lacrosse.
Right.
Shot, wall.
The Pope Greyhounds, Allen C. Pope High School here in Marietta, Georgia. There. East Cobb. I've been.
Here's a goal.
Zach Lehman.
Lehman again. Lehman with back-to-back goal. Cool. And now it's a 10-goal lead. It's 12-2.
After a quiet first half, Zach has woken up.
4:25 to go. I know Pope has a championship in girls basketball. 1999. Tiffany Wilson was the star of that ball club. Went on to star at Tulane and made a couple tournaments.
And Austin Walling.
And I know that because my school was on the losing end of it.
Bittersweet memory.
Yeah, but me and Tiffany and I, we were friends. So, and coming to Pope High School a lot of times for basketball, a lot of times for football. First time here in a while, and glad to be here for this event. There's a shot. Save. Romero with the save. The shot tip came from Austin Wall.
We're going to be in a running clock situation right now.
Yep, running clock with 4:02 to go. I'm going to be able to tell a story.
Ooh.
A shot. Goal right in there. He fired that stick in there blazing. Is that Pilcher with the goal? It is.
Yes.
Pilcher with the goal.
Goal for Pilch.
It's his second of the day.
Pilch with that goal. His second goal of the day.
He didn't want this contest to end, so he said, I'll stop the clock.
12-3. Pilch with the goal.
On the face-off, Tucker Kimbrough and Tyler Wald.
Wald, who had done a fine job with the face-off today. Whistle. Goes over to Cambridge. Cambridge has dominated the face-off today. Hence, they've dominated this ball game. In front, shot. Well, he tried to zip that in there, Miles Copeland on the attack.
Todd Copeland.
Three and a half to go. Working in back behind now. Worth. Worth going to spin long pole defense from Thomas. 3:15 to go. Corey Martini got checked, has it in the middle of the box, moves to the right of the box, bounce on the ground, roll back, and it will stay with Cambridge.
Cambridge right now is in a 2-2-2, which puts two guys on the crease, and they're pretty active guys.
Push in front, Dylan Gabriel, the midi now in. Gabriel behind the cage, fell down. Tucker Kimbrough got on him.
Holding call.
Possession will be retained to the Bears. Over near that left alley, now steps into the box. Making his move in, being pushed around. Gabriel trying to get him a shot, it wasn't there. Opening it back up, 2.5 to go. Very impressed with this Cambridge bunch. As we've talked about it a number of times now, 6 straight goals to open this contest. They've led the entire way. Gruka shot, save. Romero.
Shot, Martini.
Romero now. On the clear. It was high. Ball on the ground. Ground ball picked up there. Good job. Ryan Sadegan.
Ooh.
Young sophomore.
Out of bounds, possession War Eagles.
Woodward within possession now, and here's Dixon. Dixon right to the cage. Stop. He worked on defensively there by Lundstrom. Gonna hesitate. Move right in the middle. There's a shot.
Ooh, hit
bounce
the pipe.
Off. Curry's shot is no good.
Shot Curry.
You talked about Curry in the initiation. He tried to initiate that shot there.
All right.
Possessive Orioles.
Final 95 seconds coming up here. Twelve to three, and Cambridge now coming into the year, they were only allowing 6 goals per game, so they're going to be able to lower that number after holding Woodward to only 3 today so far. Curry with a nice little move, shot,
score,
goal. I jinxed them. Orton gives up that goal. Curry with the goal for Woodward, and it's 12-4.
Well, it's fitting Malik Curry should score because he's been carrying a lot of the offensive work for Woodward. Initiating and trying to get some shots off. So good for him.
Chandler Dorsey, a defenseman, is in on the wing area for Woodward in the white. Nick Herrick is back in for Cambridge. Violation on Cambridge. That'll give the possession to Woodward. Woodward will get a faceoff win. 12-3 in a faceoff.
1 minute. 1 minute.
Elliott, hold it back out to the top. We go under a minute. 55 seconds. Scooped up ground ball by Jack Lundstrom. Lundstrom with the pickup. And now here come Cambridge. We'll come on the clear with 40 seconds.
Herrick.
Into the box, 30 seconds.
Got to keep it in at this point.
Yep, under 2 minutes, it must stay in. And Martini came out.
Carried it out.
Unaware of that, under 2 minutes, you must keep the ball in the box.
If you're the winning team.
Woodward working around, trying to get some window dressing.
John Dixon.
Graham Dixon on that shot. Woodward will retain possession. And the final few seconds will tick off this clock. Thomas Bennett won't get a shot off. And that will be the end of the contest. Cambridge will come away with a 12-4 win. And they did it very, very, very very early, 6 straight goals in the first 8 minutes of the contest, and they were just impressive the entire way through, Bob.
They you know what?
Ladies and gentlemen,
they just had the better of it from the outset.
We
got a big game, big first half, 7 goals, and kept pumping them in the second half. I got to give credit to Woodward. They kept fighting, and they started trying to get back in the contest, but it was too little too late.
Yeah, it was too little too late, but they did show good fight there. Here in our first game for the AJO Flax Festival here at Pope High School. Glad that you've been with us right here on Crossfire TV. And do we have time for a recap? We've got a recap. Okay, 6 goals there in that first quarter. And that's when the barrage started. Jamie Wilkins got it started. Wilkins made it 1-0. And then he had a goal coming in from Jack Sadegan. Sadegan with a goal, followed by Vassell. And then it was all middies again. Zach Fuhrer with a goal. He finished with 2 goals on the day. Wilkins again, and then came in was Will Britton. And as you mentioned, the middies were doing the work there, and they got all of those first 6 goals there in that first quarter.
They did, and that was pretty good work by those middies.
Woodward was able to break onto the scoreboard and break that 6 unanswered goal streak. They got their first goal in the second quarter. Robbie Tucker at 3:27 to make it 6-1. And then finally, an attack. Griffin Chambers, his long goal of the day, made it 7-1, and that's when we went into the half, 7-1. And again, another quick start in the second half, the third quarter there, jumping off, getting it started, was Zach Fuhrer, his second goal of the day to give him an 8-1 advantage. Britton again a goal, and then Jack Meyerholt with a goal that put him up 10-1. Woodward closed it very strong. Killer Pilch with a goal. Pilch finished with 2 goals on the day. It was 10-2 as we went to the fourth quarter. Cambridge, for good measure, came in using the bench. Zach Lehman, back-to-back goals to put him up 12-2. Woodward finished with goals from Keller Pilch. And the final goal today, Malik Curry. And that is your scoring summary. 12-4 Cambridge with the win. The Bears now improve to 5-2 on the season. Woodward Academy falls 2-3. and three. And we'll take a look, and it will be Wilkins. It'll be Jamie Wilkins who will be the man of the match, the player of the game. As you see, the H.O. Flax plays across, make good choices, and celebrate life. HOFlax.com. So our next game coming up on the Crossfire TV will be Waltman, Johns Creek. Bob and I will take a break, and we'll see you later down the road. Tonight, it'll be Lambert and Lovett at 2 p.m. This has been a presentation of Crossfire TV. Right here, we'll see you in just a few moments.